In this learning module, we will consider the ways in which Spotfire pie charts may be used to visualize data, including the fact that pie sectors or wedges are defined by categorical color values and continuous size values. In addition, a pie chart which is trellised into separate panels affords the option to relate a secondary comparison by changing the size of the overall pies. Spotfire pie charts are useful whenever you need to make relative comparisons of how categorical components contribute to the total, generally expressed as a percentage. As you create pie charts, the two most important properties are the color by property, where the number of unique values determines the number of pie wedges or sectors, and the sector size by property, which can be set to represent aggregate values or counts. A secondary variable can be compared in pie chart visualizations which are split into multiple trellis panels. The pie in each trellis panel can be sized differently in order to represent that measure. For example, here we are comparing relative purchase totals in each department across states and territories. And here we have added a size by component in order to compare the total item price between states and territories. Let's take a look at a demonstration where several pie charts have already been configured. Use Open File to navigate to the example with interpreting pie charts in the title. Click Open and agree to the terms and conditions of use. The visualizations in this analysis document are based upon data from the Megamart chain of department stores. On this page, a basic pie chart visualization has been configured. The most important variables for you to know in order to interpret this pie chart are the color by values and the sector size by values. In this example, the two unique values in the gender column result in two pie sectors. The size of each sector is defined by the total shoe purchase amount made by customers of each gender. It appears that female customers contribute a much larger percentage of shoe purchases to the total than do our male customers. On the next page, the pie chart has been trellised into separate panels based upon both store setting and gender. Each pie allows us to compare the relative electronics purchase totals made at each major store location for the gender and setting defined by that panel in the trellis matrix. For example, suburban males in Seattle contribute 40% to the total electronics purchases made by suburban males across all store locations. Due to the separation of this pie chart into trellis panels, it was possible to configure a secondary variable for comparison. In this example, the size of the overall pie in each trellis panel relates the number of customers assigned to that demographic. So you can see that rural males make up the smallest number of customers, which the legend reveals to be 82, and suburban females make up the largest number of customers, which the legend reveals to be 194. Each of the remaining pie sizes is scaled between these minimum and maximum values. You may also notice that the percentage label for this Los Angeles sector is not displayed. This is because the sector percentage threshold for labels has been configured to a limit of 10% in order to keep big labels from overlapping on adjacent small pie sectors. If we hover our mouse over that sector, the tooltip information box indicates that this sum of electronics purchases made by these customers contributes only 9% to the total represented by this pie, just under the current label threshold. On the final page of this analysis document, the two pie charts configured on the left are identical, except for one feature. The sectors in this pie chart are sorted alphabetically, based upon the values in the color by property variable. That sorting starts at 12 o'clock with Boston and proceeds clockwise through Los Angeles, New York, and Seattle until 12 o'clock is reached again. This pie chart has been configured to sort sectors by size. Therefore, the largest sector percentage starts at 12 o'clock, and the sector percentages become smaller as you proceed clockwise until 12 o'clock is reached again. The pie chart on the right is designed to show you what happens when more than one categorical variable is assigned as the color by property for a pie chart. Note that for this example, each sector is sized by the count of customers, and both store setting and gender define the color by property. Therefore, a separate sector has been defined for each combination of store setting and gender. With three store setting values and two gender values, the result is a total of six sectors displayed in this pie chart. Therefore, if you wanted to know what is the percentage of suburban female customers, this pie chart would indicate that the answer is 26%.